that in. I know what I want, and I want it now. A world of instant gratification, you almost never even hear the word. And it's probably the most important word of all. It's sacrifice. See, the fifth thing we're going to need when we leave here is sacrifice. What is sacrifice? I believe it's giving up something of value to gain something of greater value. Most people aren't willing to give anything up, especially if it has value for them, the people they love. And what they don't realize is by giving up something of value, probably for the short term, we can gain some value. Some things we ascribe value to, but in fact, they're worthless. At the top of that list are our excuses. We give our excuses value by making them more important. When they're worthless, we give them value. Think about what your excuses do. You can leave here and go do something great, but you think, I failed in so many things in life. I've tried for America before and it hadn't worked out. I've been here a long time and it really hadn't worked out for me. Man, you don't understand, I'm not qualified. I don't like talking to people. I'm not a great leader. I'm too young, I'm too old, I'm too inexperienced. They're all excuses and they're all worthless. But we give them more value than our priorities in life. We make them more valuable than the things that are truly important to us because we allow them to stand in our way. Folks, if you don't do anything else while you're here in Indianapolis, leave those excuses here. Don't take them home with you. Leave them on the floor around you right now. We'll pay the crew to sweep them up. Don't take them home. Leave them here. No excuses. Your destiny is too valuable. Don't give those excuses more value than the things that are truly important. Sacrifice those and gain the results that are of so much greater value by putting those excuses aside. There's some things in life that actually have value, but we give them misplaced value. I think at the top of that list, I think of fear. You know, fear is a very powerful emotion. It's incredibly powerful. It can be valuable, it can be damaging. I believe fear can mobilize you. When we give it the wrong value, it gets in the way of what's truly important, us accomplishing our destiny, you accomplishing your destiny. Even current movies in the 60s, they would show the old black and white movies from back in the 40s. Powerful principle for life. I mean, right now, I'm telling you, my heart's beating fast just telling you about it. If a few years from now you're talking to one of your teammates and they say, whatever happened with Glenn? And I didn't see Glenn. What happened to him? And they say, I think the little man got it. You check my body for bite marks and scratches on my back. Was he might get me, but I was running when he got me. I'm telling you, I was running wide open. I was moving. I was mobilized. That's a principle that we need to deal with. Our fears are so powerful. We need to make sure that we've got them in the right place. We're not overvaluing the wrong fears. You know what scares me to death as an adult?
What?
The fear of failing to deliver on the commitments to the people I love. That's what scares me the most in life. For Karen to come up to me one day and say, Glenn, we could have had a great family if only you'd been a better husband. If only you delivered on the commitment to our kids. We could have been great, but you didn't deliver. Scares the hell out of me. For one of these great senior leaders sitting right down here in front to come up to me and say, Glenn, Primerica could have been great. We could have accomplished something so great as a company. But as CEO, you didn't deliver. You didn't give us what we needed. You didn't give us the vision, the leadership that we needed. And as a result, we failed. Scares me to death to let this group of senior leaders down. People sitting in the audience. Maybe you're sitting way in the back. Or you're sitting way up here on this side. Or you're sitting way up there on that side. Scares me to death to think that one of you would walk up to me and say, Glenn, I could change the course of history for my family, but you didn't deliver. You didn't deliver the right primary opportunity. See, all those things scare me and they keep me running. If you want to know what keeps me running, I know it's more than you. I know the psychologist would probably say I need some work, but it's the fears that keep me running. They keep me mobilized. Don't let your fears paralyze you when you leave here. Don't let the things that you dread to do paralyze you and keep you from succeeding. Replace those fears with a better, more important fear. Sacrifice those bad fears. Look for something that's more important, more valuable, that'll get you to your destiny. Hey, I know it's a scary world out there. You've got to go talk to those recruits that you need for the rest of this month. You gotta go out and do things that you never thought you could do, that you're not wired to do. Don't let those fears stop you. Replace those fears with a bigger fear of not accomplishing what you were put on this planet to accomplish. So it's pretty easy to sacrifice excuses.